happy 2014 officially. My last video I posted was with my best friend Jimmy. If you haven't checked that down below, we did the My Best Friend Does My Makeup tag. I will link it in the bottom bar, but it was like by far the funniest video that I have ever filmed. It was just, I can't believe I convinced him to do it, but it turned out really funny. He actually did a pretty good job. Like, in the moment I was like, this is bad, but I was like, no, actually, for never having like even done anyone's makeup or knows anything about makeup, he did a pretty good job. So check that out if you haven't, because it was really funny. But apart from that, I apologize about my voice and my like nasally sounding voice. I'm getting over like the longest, weirdest sickness ever. I had a sinus infection, and then that was during Christmas, and then I was fine. I was on the Z-Pack, and then I started getting just like a little bit congested, and I thought it was allergies, and then I went full-blown sick again about 2 days ago, but not like sinus infection sick, just like regular cold sick, just like congested, runny nose, all that fun jazz. Yeah, not really, but I feel like I'm finally getting better, and I just am so happy also because I finally finished all of my grad school applications, and I've been working on this for about 3 months. So 2014 I think is gonna be a really weird year for me. I'm planning on going to grad school, and for me personally, I'm applying to business school, so I'm planning on getting my MBA and planning away full-time, 2 years, no job, just school, which is going to be a transition in of its own. And I'm also, I didn't apply to any schools in Charlotte, so I'm going to be moving hopefully in August to who knows where. I probably won't know exactly what school I get into for a few months. But anyways, I did want to share that little part of my life, why I've been kind of MIA and why it's just I'm always kind of running around crazy. And yeah, so I wanted to start off 2014 with best of, did I say 2014? Yeah, with the best of 2013 beauty favorites. And I did a video similar to this last year, and I'll link that down below because I was re-watching it in preparation for this video a few weeks back actually. And honestly, all the products that I mentioned, I still use. So check that out down below because I didn't want to repeat some of the products since it's the same thing as last year. I'm going to be doing the video in two parts because I just have a lot of things I want to talk to you guys about. Because I think 2013 was the year I officially went from liking makeup to being like completely and utterly obsessed with makeup. So I've always loved beauty products, but this was the year that I went a little bit like cray, you know, the official breakdown of I need this, I need that, and I need it now. So regardless, I guess that makes for better videos for you guys because I've been able to try out a lot of different products and let you guys know what I really and truly like. So this video is going to be just showcasing makeup, and the next video, which will be the one after this, is going to be my favorite skincare, body care, and hair care items of 2013. So let's go ahead and start with the favorite makeup products from 2013. And just FYI, I'm not going to be doing like particular like categories, like one of each. It's kind of like all over the place. So I'm going to start off with my favorite foundation, and this foundation quickly has become my holy grail foundation, my favorite foundation, the one I reach for every day, and that foundation is the Urban Decay Naked Skin Foundation. I wear the color 2.0, and ever since I bought this product, it has kind of been one of those life-changing foundations. It's so lightweight. It never looks cakey, it never looks powdery. It has such a beautiful finish on your skin that I have recommended this foundation to so many people. It's a great, amazing foundation. Previous to this, I was using the Tarte Amazonian Clay, which I do really like that foundation, and also the Laura Mercier Silk Cream. And I was in the mood to kind of go from a creamy, full coverage foundation to something a little bit lighter, since I don't really need to wear a full coverage foundation. I don't really have problematic skin. And even if you do have problematic skin, I would think that even covering your blemishes or something up with a thicker concealer and then using this foundation, so you don't have to hide your skin. The name says Naked Skin. It really does do what the name says. It's a very kind of like just a second skin. I use a very little amount every day, and what I do really like about this product is that a little goes a long way, and not only that, but it's buildable. So every day when I go to work, I just, you know, pump a little bit on my hand, just like one pump, and that covers my full face pretty nicely. But when I'm going out at night or know that I'm going to take a lot of pictures, I will, you know, build it up. And it's not those, you know, there's those types of foundations that you build it up and it starts to look cakey or like a little bit, it looks like you're wearing too much foundation. It never happens with this. If I want to have a more full, flawless coverage, I will just add a little bit more foundation and it works perfectly. So this is my holy grail. I love it. I love it. So happy I discovered it in 2013. All right, so next up is the concealer category. And if you've been following me for a while, you know that I have a really big problem with concealers. I just have this really weird kind of complex about my under eyes and think that they're really, really bad when in reality, I feel like they're pretty average, not super bad, but I do try to find the one, if you know what I mean. Like, I'm just always searching and like, maybe I'm like, oh, this is gonna be the one, that one's gonna be the one, no, this one is, no, this combination of these. You know, like a typical crazy makeup person. I think I found my like holy grail concealer this year and it's very expensive and it's high end and it's more than any, it's the price is more than I've ever paid for a concealer. This is the La Mer concealer. I think the actual name is the Radiant Concealer, and it has SPF 25. I think this is around $70. It might be a little bit more, which is, yes, I know that's a lot. 0.11 ounces. I don't know if that means anything, but the little like packaging it comes in is so cute and I just love it. It is a godsend. It's a really like pretty, it is a like more of a pinkish toned concealer, I would say. Definitely the best thing I've ever used for my under eye circles. It like literally erases them the moment you apply it to your under eyes. Beautiful concealer. Can't say enough amazing things about this concealer. And I know it's pricey, but I feel like it's one of those concealers that's going to last me a long time. I feel like there's a lot of product in here. I think that's probably why it costs so much. I feel like if it was smaller, they could probably lower down the price, but it is a pretty nice size concealer. But I will be doing a review on the La Mer concealer paired with the Tom Ford highlighting pen. Tom Ford was the brand that literally blew me away this year. And I obviously, when the first time I experienced it and I got my face done when I was in Chicago, and I was at the Tom Ford counter, I wanted to buy everything. Obviously, you know, who has $1,000 laying around where you can just be like, yeah, just this blush, this foundation. I mean, all of his items, everything that I've been able to try on my skin have been the most high quality, beautiful, amazing cosmetics that I've ever tried. So anytime that I've run out of something, I've been like, maybe I'll try the Tom Ford one. Maybe I'll try the Tom Ford of that. So I picked up the Tom Ford highlighting pen in Naked Bisque, and I actually got the La Mer and the Tom Ford one together, or like I ordered them both at the same time. I had had this one, the guy who did my makeup at the Tom Ford counter when I went, put this one on my skin and I was like, I'm buying that the moment that I run out of like my Maybelline highlighting pen. So it is just like, you know, the name says, a highlighting pen very similar to like the YSL Touche Clat or even the Maybelline one. I would say they're similar in the colors that I have the Maybelline Dream Lumi pen in Radiant, which is one that I'm gonna also talk about. So love this, you guys. Love, love, love. So what I've been doing is I've been using this just under my eyes like this, patting it in. I find that it works best just with your fingers. I haven't even been using a concealer brush. And then what I do with the highlighting pen is I will put a little bit here and here, and then I work those up like this with my fingers. And I find that it's been the best combination I've discovered in a few years. I used to use the Bobbi Brown corrector. So if you are in the market and if you have the money to spend on the best under eye concealer you will ever use, definitely check out the La Mer concealer. The Tom Ford highlighting pen, I think it's only around $50, which again is really pricey. I'm saying only because compared to the La Mer concealer, but the Tom Ford highlighting pen I think is the best highlighting pen I've ever used in my entire life as well. But I quickly wanted to mention my favorite drugstore concealers because these are some that I have consistently gone to, and two concealers that I feel like are better than a lot of just like higher end concealers that I've tried. One of them is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Concealer. I wear the color light pale. This is another one, is one of my go-tos. If I'm not in the mood to wear the La Mer and the Tom Ford one, just on the weekends, I will just wear these. This is a really good concealer. It's very kind of lightweight. The other one I wanted to mention is also by Maybelline. It's the Dream Lumi pen, highlighting pen in Radiant. Love this one. Very similar to the Tom Ford one, except this one usually lasts me about 2 months or maybe a little bit less. There's not a lot of product in here, and it's also not that much, it doesn't have that much coverage. I mean, I don't know if you guys can see that. It's also a pink salmon-y based one. I've gone through so many of these, probably like 6 or 7, and this combo is one that I always go back to. Even if, say, I don't want to rebuy the La Mer because it's $70, this one is a good option. If you're more inclined towards drugstore alternatives, I would go with these two concealers together. So let's talk about my favorite powder that I discovered. And I was using the Rimmel Stay Matte for a good part of the year, which is a great drugstore alternative if you're looking for a really nice, like, mattifying powder to set your makeup. But this one is the powder that blew me away this year. It is by NARS, and it is the NARS Light Reflecting Setting Powder in Translucent. So it is a very interesting powder because it's like, it's completely like translucent, and I don't know if you can, guys can see, it's kind of like white. You would think that, oh, that looks like a highlighter, but when applied to the skin, it doesn't leave any residue except a beautiful kind of matte satiny finish. So it's not a matte finish where it makes your skin look dull, which I think that the Rimmel Stay Matte had a little bit of that residue, and it kind of like ruined if your foundation was looking really nice and you just wanted to set it. This is amazing because it's not gonna like mess with the finish of your foundation or mess with just like your skin's texture, which a lot of powders tend to do. I think that they tend to look powdery. Never with this. This is such an amazing product. I picked this one back up in, I think, April or May. And again, I mean, I've been using it every day and I just started to hit a little bit of pan on it. So really great product. I love this powder and really recommend it. So this year was the year of the blush for me, I think, too. I have three that I try to narrow it down, and three, they're kind of different, that I wanted to share that were like my standout blushes of the year. Number one, and I think the one that I used for the most part of this year, is another one by NARS, and this one is NARS Madly Blush. It is a beautiful brownish taupe blush, kind of hinting towards the more purplish shades. I don't know if you guys are able to see that. I love this. This is one of those blushes that goes with like basically any look. If you're like kind of struggling, like, I don't know which blush to wear today, this one is amazing. Madly is a shade I would recommend to virtually anyone. Such a beautiful blush. NARS blushes obviously are extremely high quality, beautifully pigmented. I just love Madly. Another standout blush this year was the Benefit Rock Couture blush. This is the rose gold shade I feel like everyone talked about for a month there. I don't want to blind you guys, but there is the beautiful blush. I'm wearing it today. I feel like this is the blush I reached the most for because it is very, even though it's really pigmented, you can kind of play around with it and it's never going to be like, oh my gosh, I need to like spend 10 hours applying my blush, because it's very shimmery, just so beautiful. I love this blush. It's amazing. Last but not least, I got my first Chanel blush about a few months ago, and it lives up to the name. This is Chanel's blush in Emotion. It is a beautiful rosy-ish tint. Just beautiful. A little bit reminiscent of MAC Melba, if you guys have that. It is so pigmented. This is one of those shades that you just need to have a very light hand. It's here if you guys can't see it. You just need to have a very light hand when you apply it. I was not really expecting to love this as much as I did. It makes me want to go and pick up like every single Chanel blush shade because they're so beautifully pigmented and they look so beautiful on the skin. I'm pretty sure this may have been in the holiday collection if I'm not mistaken, but it is number 87 Emotion, and it is a beautiful, beautiful blush. And these three blushes have just been so, like, I don't need any more than these three. I also have two highlighters that I wanted to talk about, one being the Dior Amber Diamond Shimmer, whatever it is, shimmer powder. This one, I feel like, again, has been talked about so much. Beautiful, beautiful highlighting powder. This one, I feel like I'm more inclined to use it around summertime just because it is a little bit shimmery. I haven't been reaching for it in the past few months, but I wanted to include it because I wore it like every single day this summer. And I wore it again tonight because I was like, I want to remember. And I just was like, oh my gosh, it is so beautiful. It is so pretty. It really lives up to everything that you hear about this powder. It's worth the money, worth the splurge. Gorgeous. NARS Albatross, compared to the Dior one, is a lot more, I would say, matte, in as much as a highlighter can be matte. It is kind of like a more sheen as opposed to shimmer that you're putting on your skin. It is just to die for. Beautiful, beautiful highlighter as well. I think that if you're looking to get two higher end highlighters, these two should be your go-tos. They're absolutely stunning, beautiful highlighters. I had one standout bronzer in 2013, and this is the bronzer that I've used every single day since I bought it. It is the Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer. This is the one in the medium deep, and it's a beautiful matte bronzer. I use it, literally use it every single day. It is gorgeous, and I haven't hit pan on it, even though I bought this back in like April or maybe March, actually. I can't, oh my god, it smells like chocolate. I forgot to mention that. It smells so good. Even with my stuffed up nose, like when I close it, the smell of like chocolate came to me. So it's a beautiful, amazing bronzer. If you are in the market for like a matte bronzer to wear every single day, it really has no shimmer, no sheen, but it never leaves your skin looking like muddy or orange or anything like that. It's a beautiful, beautiful bronzer that just makes you look bronzed. Moving on to the eyebrow category, this is the Anastasia Brow Wiz. I wear the color medium ash and I am obsessed with this. Previous to this year, I was kind of like, I don't need to fill my eyebrows in, but then I kind of realized, yes, I do need to fill my eyebrows in. This is amazing. I've only been using this since September, and I literally, it's part of my everyday routine now. I can't leave the house without putting this on, and it is an amazing product because it has the little pen here, and you don't need to sharpen it. You can just twist it up whenever you run out of little coal, and then it has this little spoolie that this thing, when you like put it on your eyebrows, it makes it, I use it before I put on the before I put on the brow color and after, because it just makes everything look so natural, so beautiful. Can't explain how much I love this product. If there's anything that you'll buy from this video, make it this one, because this is going to be the one like life-changing product. It's just amazing and I can't live without it now. For mascara, I have one, and it is the Giorgio Armani Eyes to Kill. This I picked up a few months ago and it has quickly become my absolute go-to favorite mascara. I use it every single day. This was an original Makeup by Tiffany D recommendation, but ever since I started using it, I'm like, oh my gosh, what was I doing without this mascara? It's not a mascara that is going to like change your eyelashes forever, and you're not gonna like, you know, people aren't gonna ask if you wear false lashes, but it is a beautiful mascara that just makes your eyelashes look really long, very full, very volumized, and just really like in a natural way. Definitely what I'm looking for to wear to work every day. So moving on to eyes, there was a big standout eyeshadow palette quad thing that I purchased this year, and it was by Mr. Tom Ford himself. This is the Tom Ford eyeshadow quad in Cognac Sable. Beautiful. I actually did a full review on this, so I will link that review in the information bar down below in case you guys want to check that out. Gorgeous, beautiful shades, nothing like this. I mean, I feel like I've heard so many people talk about his shades, and what it boils down to is not the colors, and it's like the colors are maybe something you've seen before, but it's just the quality of the eyeshadows. They're to die for. Amazing, beautiful, buttery, pigmented, and so blendable. They're definitely worth the money. So Tom Ford eyeshadow quads, if you're gonna go with one to start off, I would either get this one or the Coco Mirage. They're so beautiful, and I promise you won't regret it. Another small little eye thing is the Benefit Creaseless Cream Shadow in RSVP. I use this every single day as like my eyeshadow base. Even if I don't wear another eyeshadow on top, it is a really pretty pink champagne-ish base that looks like you kind of tried your eye makeup when you really didn't. All I do is just sweep this a little bit if I'm in a rush and add a little bit of a matte brown in my crease and you're good to go. So now we've reached the lip product portion of this video. I tried to narrow it down as much as I could. The standout drugstore items for me were the NYX Butter Glosses. I have three right here that I wanted to share quickly. This is Tiramisu, this is Cherry on Top, and this one is Peaches and Cream. They are so buttery. They're the NYX Butter Glosses. Very creamy. They last a long time. I would say that these are some of my favorite lip glosses ever. They're so pretty and they're very inexpensive. So if you have not checked out the NYX Butter Glosses, you definitely should. I find mine at Ulta. I know that Target recently started carrying NYX, so you'll probably find them. If not, you can find them online. I think 2013, like I said before, was a year I started being like really crazy obsessed with makeup. And I just began buying a lot of higher end stuff as well. I have become obsessed with high-end lip products, and honestly, it does matter, I think, for my particular taste. So some of my favorite lip products are the Chanel Rouge Coco Shines, which is, I'm actually wearing one right now in the, I think this one is called Fiction? Yeah, Fiction. Number 81. It is a beautiful, kind of like a rosy, kind of like a dark raspberry. I love this color. I also have the Rouge Coco Shine here in Boy, which is a beautiful everyday nudish pink mauvey toned. Love these. The Rouge Coco Shines are worth the money, you guys. They're so great. Obviously Chanel, you can't really go wrong, but they're just beautiful. I love them. Moving on to Dior, a standout product for me are the Dior Addict lip glosses. They're so beautiful. Very non-sticky formulas, but they're very shiny and very like glittery, so they're super pretty. This one is in Night Fantasy. I have a few others that I really like as well. And then I also wanted to quickly shout out the Dior Addict lip glosses. I'm sorry, lipsticks. It's just the Dior Addict lipstick. I know there's like an Extreme and then there's a Dior Rouge or something like that. This one is really pretty, kind of similar to the Rouge Coco Shines from Chanel. I would say that these have more of a matte finish. Those have more of a glossy finish, but really like these. This is the only Dior Addict lipstick I have, but it's been one that I've been reaching for like every single day ever since I bought it. YSL, why do you have to be so beautiful? Last year I talked about the Rouge Volupt line. Now I'm talking to you guys about the Rouge Volupt Shines. The Rouge Volupt Shines are new this year, I'm pretty sure, and they completely blew me out of the lip products world. Like, I want to buy every single color of these. This one is Fuchsia in Excess, and it is number 5. And this one I think was sold only at Sephora. Beautiful. These are like the Rouge Volupts, except they are more wearable. I find the Rouge Volupts to be kind of hard to wear, very creamy, and just a little bit smeary, if you know what I mean. But these are amazing. And this one is in number 13, which I don't remember the name. But this is a more of a day-to-day pinkish color. Love these products. They're amazing. You cannot beat the luxurious packaging of these YSLs. They're just amazing. Last but not least, I wanted to talk about my man, Tom Ford. I'm just so obsessed with his line. It's really crazy. This is the Tom Ford lip color in number 3, Casablanca. Just picked this up about a month ago, if that. The most beautiful lipstick you will ever put on your lips. It's honestly, it doesn't look like anything special in the tube, but it is a beautiful, gorgeous, long-lasting formula. It's creamy, it's pigmented, it's just stunning, and it's so luxurious. His lipsticks are amazing. I just can't, like, I find, like, I'm overwhelmed by how much I like all of these lip products. I want to buy, like, all of them at once. That's crazy, I know. Is the Tom Ford Lip Gloss, and this one is in Peach Absolute. Amazing. Beautiful lip gloss. This is probably my favorite lip gloss, along with the Dior Addict, and I really like the Chanel Glossomers as well, but these two have been the more standouts for me this year. This one I have used so much ever since I picked it up a few months back. Gorgeous, 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 gorgeous. Doesn't, I mean, you can just tell how excited I am about these by what I'm acting like in this video, like a little girl. But love this. Tom Ford, oh my gosh, just I'm obsessed with everything in his line and I can't wait to buy more. I'm crazy. All right, you guys, so that was my video on my favorite products makeup-wise for 2013. Stay tuned for the next video where I'm gonna be talking about my favorite hair care, skincare, and body care of 2013. I thought, obviously, this video was so long, it would have been a much longer video if I included those. But thank you guys so much for watching and for subscribing. As always, I have all of the products listed and linked down below, just so you guys aren't gonna be searching around all these websites. I have everything listed down below in case you guys are interested. I also have all of my social media accounts, my Facebook, my blog, my Twitter, my Instagram. Definitely follow me and let me know that you are watching me from YouTube or whatever, and I just love to hear from you guys and get feedback and all of that. Leave any requests or comments down below, and thank you guys for watching, and I will talk to you guys another day. Bye.